job. I just didn't have the time for the night shift anymore. Anyway, a pity party won't get you through your first night. Henry wanted me to give you a quick rundown on how everything works, so get ready. For starters, you can access the surveillance cameras on the monitor in front of you. Go ahead and pull them up. Great. Here, you'll be able to monitor the entrances and the animatronic characters. Some of these cameras are pretty dark, so I ended up messing with that old flashlight system the previous owner had in the diner. I jerry-rigged it to the camera. There should be a button on the bottom right of the screen. Why don't you give it a press? Can't tell you how many times it saved my life. Job. Saved my job. Okay. Well, anyway. You should also know about the power-saving procedure that the building undergoes during morning hours. You'll notice lights flickering, electrical noises, and even sometimes short outages. Don't get nervous when this stuff happens. It's all normal. The building will allocate more power automatically, so your lights will be back on in a couple of seconds. Sometimes certain cameras will go dark, and you'll have to reactivate them manually. There's a fuse box right behind where you're sitting. Pop it open. When you open it up, you'll see the tape I put on each switch to indicate which camera it controls. Use them to reactivate any camera that goes dark. I'm not a master electrician, but the wiring will get the job done. There weren't enough switches for all of the cameras, so I only hooked up the most important ones. The remaining ones are wired up to the main breaker in the parts and service room. You won't need to worry about those. As you've seen during the day shift, the animatronics love to stretch their legs, even when they are supposed to be up. Henry had some technical explanation about their joints locking up or something, but I didn't pay much attention. If you don't see them on the cameras, you can check the hallway with your flashlight. Henry and William both assured me that the animatronics were harmless. But just in case, I figured out a way to get them to leave the office. At least with the newer models, they were designed to interact with other characters. So I snatched an old Freddy headpiece from the parts and service room. Putting that on your head will trick the newer models into thinking you're one of them. Try it out. It might smell though. It's pretty old. Great. One more thing. You'll hear an alarm periodically once they start moving. All this means is that an animatronic tripped one of the ventilation motion sensors. Alright, I think that's everything for tonight. I'm not gonna call you again. You know, with the boss breathing over my shoulder. not gonna monitor any of my calls after your first shift. Yippee, right? Now I can say whatever I want. Think of dropping you a few more messages during your first week wouldn't hurt, especially considering the situation you're in right now. Remember when you used to do maintenance on those older models during the day shifts? They always gave me the creeps, like they were staring right through me. They were fine with the kids back at the old diner, but here, something feels off about them. And let me tell you, despite whatever reassurance William might try to give you, those things get aggressive after hours. They've trashed the place multiple times when I was on night duty, and I almost lost my job because of it. Anyway, I learned the hard way that the Freddy mask won't fool them. You know that Fox character I was talking about? Foxy the Pirate? The one they decommissioned back at the diner? He's going to either stare right into one of your cameras, or stare at you right down the hallway. Those older models have always been sensitive to light. It was one of their main flaws. You can get Foxy to go away by shining your flashlight at him for a couple of seconds, or by using that camera beacon I talked about yesterday. I think you know the real reason I installed it now. Anyway, he'll make some weird garbled noises once he leaves. I think it just means that his system is rebooting. I'll get him to leave you alone at least. If you don't get him to go away fast enough, God help you. Okay, what I'm about to say stays only between you and me, alright? I caught a glimpse of William fitting those older models today with newer parts. I checked the maintenance logs, and sure enough, there's nothing there about repairing the old models. I don't know what he's up to, and I'm kind of tempted to go to Henry about it. I think I'm just gonna wait, see if he does anything else that Henry wouldn't approve of. I think that's everything for tonight. I'll probably have some more information for you tomorrow. Remember, I never called you, okay? Alright, good night. Seriously, take one look at that animatronic and tell me it wouldn't traumatize you as a kid. I've never seen her move during my shifts, but if she ever activates, somehow, the Freddy mask trick should work on her too. Remember, the mask works only on the newer models. As I said last night, William started fitting those older models with new parts. I think Freddy was the one he was messing with, because I heard that tune from the old diner in there today. I'm just taking a wild guess, but if William is using the newer parts, Freddy will be able to walk around too, which he was never able to before. Depending on the parts William is using, he may or may not be fooled by the mask. If not, the flash beacon should still work on drawing him away. Anyway, the day shift was interesting, to say the least. The janitor began to complain about a strange smell coming from the parts and service room. The room was locked up tight, but the smell was coming through the sill of the door. Smell like mold? Maybe a rat or something died there. I tried to find William so I could ask, but he was nowhere to be found. And, I've got some news about Henry. It turns out his daughter went missing a couple of days ago. They filed a missing persons report and everything, but still no leads. Just wanted to let you know that's why he hasn't been coming in. God, I hope she's alright. Anyway, I'll let you get back to it. Keep safe, Michael. And, if you need anything, I'm just a call away. Good night.
Thank you.
face, but he locked himself in that damn parts and service room again. The smell has gotten way worse, like something's rotten in there. I caught William after closing to ask him what he was doing, but he just told me to focus on my own duties and keep my nose out of his business. I don't even know what to think. Anyway, if any more of the older mobs are active tonight, which I'm certain they will be, keep shining their face with your flashlight. Since they're not fooled by the mask, if you wear it when they're crawling up to you in the vent, it might be too late. My advice would be to hold a flashlight at whichever vent entrance they're coming through before they make it to your office. You'll probably be able to distinguish them from the rest just by the weird sounds they make. A thought just hit me, Michael. William locks the parts and service store before he leaves. How in the world are the older models leaving that room? Only he has the key. I don't suppose you can check. No, it's fine. I wouldn't risk it. Just stay in your office. You're safest there. If I get the chance tomorrow, I'm gonna sneak into the parts and service room while it's unlocked to find out what William is doing in there. If it's what I think it is, never mind. I'll let you know what's going on. Good night, Michael. Stay safe.
Thank you.
Finish your shift. I'll stop moving at 6 a.m., I'm sure of it. I know he's hiding something in there. I just know it. God, it was so close. Look, Michael, I don't care if I'm out of a job now. This is bigger than that. There's something going on in that parts and service room. And given what happened back at the old diner, I think I know what it is. You're the only one left who can get in there without raising suspicion. Please, just finish your shift and take a look for me. If it's what I think it is, you might want to call the police. I owe you big time, man.
Thank you.
service room anymore. Just get the hell out. He knows you're in the middle of your shift. There's no other reason he would be there than to... Just get out. I'm waiting outside in my car right now. It's hidden in the foliage. I called the police, but they won't be here for a while. This place is in the middle of nowhere. Wait. He's messing with something outside of the building. Hold on. Thank you.